bankroll Sri Lanka defaulted on billions of dollars of external debt, leaving the island nation with no food, no fuel, and no medicines. At least 500,000 people fell into poverty. In April, Sri Lanka defaulted on billions of dollars of external debt, leaving the island nation with no food, no fuel, and no medicines. At least 500,000 people fell into poverty. In April, Sri Lanka defaulted on billions of dollars of external debt, leaving the island nation with no food, no fuel, and no medicines. At least 500,000 people fell into poverty.
Sri Lanka's economic collapse needs immediate global attention, not just from humanitarian agencies, but from international financial institutions, private lenders, and other countries who must come to the country's aid.
What followed was daily power blackouts, widespread protests on the streets, lengthy queues outside petrol stations, and all of that led to the fall of the long-standing Rajapaksa government. Sri Lanka looked like government offices run over, public broadcaster hijacked, presidential palace ransacked, prime minister's office set ablaze, and president having to fled the country unceremoniously. As a reporter based in South Asia, I have covered numerous protests over a decade, but nothing compares to what Sri Lanka witnessed this year. But how did things go so bad? Sri Lanka's biggest industries are tourism and agriculture. Experts say while the coronavirus pandemic killed the tourism sector, a ban on chemical fertilizers introduced by the then President Gotabaya Rajapaksa damaged the agricultural sector. The import-dependent country ran out of money as its reserves completely depleted.
In November 2019, our foreign exchange reserves were at $7.5 billion. However, today, it is a challenge for the Treasury to find $1 million. We must prepare ourselves to make some sacrifices and face the challenges of this period.
As we bid goodbye to 2022, the queues have gone away, but not the pain. The supplies have somewhat restored, but the inflation remains. The new government was hoping to get a $3 billion bailout package from the IMF by December. But to secure that, it had to renegotiate loans with its foreign lenders, tighten budget spendings, and boost revenues. But it looks like time is running out for Sri Lanka, and that it'll miss the December deadline, which simply means more trouble for the island nation of 22 million people.